It's quite natural that when a new textbook gets introduced, the very first unit will be attended with utmost interest. So was it with the first unit of the 10th standard as well. The name of the unit, as you can see, is Generations. It actually emphasizes the widening generation gap, which is actually a common characteristic feature of the present day society. It in fact exhorts us to maintain mutual love and respect in between members of the different generations. The unit has got 4 reading material pieces. In fact, in addition to this, there comes a range of structural items which are very much used in everyday existence. In fact, fathers help the in-depth prose material which is written by R.K. Narayanan, Night of the Scorpion, an in-depth poem written by Nizamizakiel, Games at Twilight, an extended prose material, and Once Upon a Time, an extended poetic piece. In fact, Father's Help, written by R.K. Narayanan, is a real icing on the cake. With his Malgudi days, R.K. Narayanan has left an unforgettable mark upon the Indo-Anglian literature. Father's Help is a beautiful story which was so interesting for the students. It actually tells us of the futile attempts by Swami, a boy who actually doesn't want to go to school. In fact, he presents a lot of lame excuses before his father. To his father, he says that he has to confront with a teacher, Samuel, who is a very cruel indeed. Then the father's actually supplies him with a letter to be delivered to the headmaster of the school, and Swami thinks that this letter details the cruelties of Samuel, sir, as he has actually mentioned to his father. Throughout the day, Swami was trying his level best to get punished by the Samuel, sir, so that the contents of the letter can be justified. And it was only at the 11th hour that his efforts gets of course fruited, in fact, and gets fruited, and so that the contents of the letter could be justified. He rushed out of the classroom after getting punished by Samuel, sir, only to get informed by the peon of the school that the HM was on leave and the charge was entrusted to Samuel, sir. In fact, he fled in fear instantaneously. It's a very beautiful story which has actually paved the a way for students to think and enjoy it to the maximum. The story offers a sea of chances for discourses, in fact, especially for the construction of discourses. The letter written by the father to the headmaster provides the very mystic charm of the story. And throughout the classrooms, of course, it has been the contents of the letter has been well debated and well discussed, and it has paved way for a vista of divergent thinking. There is every chance that this particular letter has got so important as far as the examination point of view is concerned. So definitely this question gets paramount importance. Suppose you are the father of Swami, draft the letter you had written to the headmaster. Actually, a model letter is being given. I am the father of Swami, a student reading in the C division of the 6th standard. I write this letter in order to bring to your kind attention some important factors relating to my son. Nowadays, he shows no interest in coming to school. Every morning, he gets up with excuses for not going to school. He had been so sincere and punctual to his studies till last year, but presently it seems that he is so disinterested. Hope you will share this matter to his class teacher, Mr. Samuel, whom he has placed in high esteem. I would be greatly obliged if you would have a personal chat with him. Yours faithfully, signature. In fact, another letter that can be asked for the examination is, suppose you are Swami, write a letter to your friend detailing all the important happenings on the day. In fact, this particular letter is actually making Swami write or look at the incidents in his own perspective. Since Father's Help is a perfect narrative, it actually offers a sea of chances for the for drafting diary entries as well. A diary, as we all know, is a personal reminiscence, and here are some points to be borne in mind while preparing diaries, making diary entries. A diary is a personal reflection. Its language is more informal and of narrative mold. Ideas to be properly arranged. Events other than routine ones are to be mentioned, need not be in full sentences. Actually, that's a very important criteria for a diary writing. Now, this particular question has got paramount importance as far as the examination point of view is concerned. Suppose the father makes the diary entry of the important incidents of the day in which he wrote the letter to the HM. How will it be? Day and date references. As usual, went for the morning walk, returning found Swami still in bed. He presented lame excuses for not going to school, cooked up some stories against his class teacher, Mr. Samuel. Swami seemed afraid to go to school late. To give him confidence, I wrote a letter with instructions to hand it over to HM. Oh, I was sure he wouldn't deliver it. Exactly the same thing happened. Another discourse that can be expected is describing physical features. We know the sixth paragraph of the course book contains, actually that particular father's help extract contains, a beautiful description of Samuel in fact. In tune with that particular description, you can be asked to make a physical description of your friend. When such a description is made, the following attributes may be of great help. General appearance, as far as the general appearance is concerned, tall, lean, fat, bulky, short, stout, small structured. Of course, these connotations can be used. And as far as color of the skin is concerned, you can make it as a fair complexion, dark complexion, dim complexion, pale looking, etc. And as far as hair is concerned, long luxuriant hair, short thick, bushy headed, bald headed, trimmed up to, of course, curly headed. All these connotations can be of help when we refer to hair in fact. As far as face is concerned, it can be a squarish face or it can be a roundish face.